How are you? I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to continue our maths chapter. Number work. In previous class you all have learned the number names, numbers, before and after, biggest and smallest. I showed you that also in previous class what you have learned. I have given that revisions also in the first video. Now I am going to teach the second part. Part 2. What you are going to learn in the part 2? Just look at here. Understanding 3-digit numbers. Now from 1 to 99 you all know how to write. After 100, 101, 102, there are lot of numbers are there up to 999. How will you going to write that 3-digit numbers? So look at here. 3-digit numbers have hundreds, tens and ones. Ones means it's a unit. 3-digit numbers have hundreds, tens and ones. Ones means unit. Unit means you have 1 to 9. That all unit number. Then 10 to 99. All are tens number. And the 100 from 100 to 999, all the 100 places. So 3-digit numbers have hundreds, tens and ones. We can use model of hundreds. Here I have given some models of hundreds and tens and ones are there. That I will explain you afterwards. Just look at whatever I am going to teach you today. So we can use models of hundreds, tens and ones to write 3-digit number. A century is 100, means a whole number 100. A smallest 2-digit number is 10. And the biggest 2-digit number, can you tell what is that? 99. Yes. After 10, 11, 12, you are going on continuing up to 99. You are stopping the 2-digit number over there, 99. Now, a smallest 3-digit number. Which is the smallest 3-digit number? 100. You start from the 100 and you stop up to 3-digit. Biggest 3-digit number is 999. The place of hundreds. A short form of 100 is H, is written for hundreds place. The place of tens is written short form as T, is written for tens. The place of units, U, is written for units. Now look at here, how I wrote here, just for an example. H means 100, T means tens and U means units. So unit also we can say ones, okay, because it's a single number. Tens means double, twice, and 100 means 3-digit number. So now we are going to learn these 3-digit numbers. So are you all ready to learn? So look at here, 3-digit numbers. First read the 100 place digit and then read the other 2 digits together. Now look at here. Look at these boxes. There is a square. How many squares are there? Only one square is there. But in that, how many squares are made inside that? Short. So you will learn this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So how many lines are there total? How many rows are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 tens make how many? 100. 10 tens make 100. Is that clear? 10 tens make 100. So now I cut at that part and I have made that 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here is 10, means 1 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here is the second. So how many tens are there total? 10 and 10, how much? 10 and 10 is how much, children? Can you tell me? It's a 20. So 20 tens. And here is how much? 100. How much? 100. And here, the unit. This is a single number. So all the things I have cut it and I have put it in the single way. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 units. So this is the things. 100 means one box has 100 boxes are inside. And these are, there are 2 tens. So it's become 20. So what is the question answer you are going to write here? 124. 124. So how will you going to write here? 124. Like this way the answer will going to come here. 124. So how will you going to write in the spellings? So what can you tell me, what is the spelling of 1? O N E. 100 H U N D R E D. 100. Then 2. 2 means it's a 20. So can you tell me the spelling of 20? 100 T W E N T Y. 20. Last one, a single number 4. What is the spelling of 4? F O U R. So 124. We have to spell like this way. 124. The number is 124. So how you find out these things? it's an easy method. So look at here. Oh God, there are two boxes are there. So are you confused? No? No. So total in one box, how many? I told you that boxes are small boxes are there. 10. So 10 tens, 100. Now there are two. So what we are going to write here? Can you tell me? 10 tens make 100. Here 2 tens means 20 tens. 20 tens make 200. 20 tens make 200. Because, right, is it clear? Now in the tens place, I told you here is a 10, here 10 and here 10. So how much it become? 3 tens are there, no? 1, 2 and 3. So here 10, here 10 and here 10. So how much tens are there? 3 tens are so. You will say that 3 tens means it's become 30. 3 tens become 30. Now single number, how many are there? 1 and 2. So how will you going to write here? Only single number because there is nothing is there over there. So we will just write 2 units. What are you going to write here? 2 units. So can you tell me the whole number together? If you make a what, which number will going to come there? 232. Is that clear? 232, the answer will be. The answer will be 232. So how will you spell this? Before that, we have to write first unit, tens, 100. So 2 is in 100 place. So write here 2, 100 spelling, H, U, N, D, R, E, D, 100, correct? Then 3 is in tens place. So it become 30. So 3 tens, 30. So 30, what is spelling of 30? T-H-I-R-T-Y, 30. Then 2, a single number. So you have to write here 32. So 232 is the answer. Now look at your children. There are two bags. How many bags are there? Two bags. What was written on that bag? H. H means 100. And how many triangles are over there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 triangles are there. How many triangles? 5 triangles. And what they have written on that? T. T means tens. And the single beads, how many are there? 4 beads are there. Single beads, 4 are there. So what is the answer will come? 254. 254 means 2 is 100, tens is 5 and 4 is single bits. So you have to write that 254 means 254, and you have to write the spelling also there. So 254 spelling, you have to write the words. Now look at the second example, children. How many bags are there? Just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many bags are there? 6 bags. And how many triangles are there? 1. How many triangles are there? 1. And how many single beads are there? Just count properly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many are there? 5 beads are there. So total how many are there? 610. 10 means 0. 0 is nothing valid. So take this unit number with the tens number. So what will come there? 615. What will come there? 615. Now look at the third one. Now you itself count how many bags are there. Just I want to hear. 1, very good. 2, 3, 4. How many bags are there? 4 bags. Very good. How many triangles are there? 1, 2, 3. How many triangles are there? 3. Means it's a tens. 3, 30. And the single numbers are 1, 2, 3. Single bits are 3. So what is the answer, children? 433. 30 means I told you 0 value is nothing. So take the unit numbers with that tens. So it's become 433. Go through the third one. Look at here properly, children. How many bags are there? My goodness, so many bags are here. Just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many bags are there? 7. And how many triangles are there, children? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 triangles are there and the single bead is 1. So what will be the answer? Can you tell me what is the answer? 741. What is the answer? 741. So how will you going to write that? 7, 4 and then 1. So it becomes 741. Now look at the last sums, children. What is your? How many single beads are there? Just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many single beads are there? 9 single beads are there. Is that clear? Just check it out once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
8, 9. Exactly, there are 9 beads are there. Where is the triangle? Can you see the triangle? No, triangle is not there. That means tens is not there. Only the units and 100 is there. So, how many, in 100, how many bags are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 800 and only you have to count now unit with that. Unit is how much? 9. So, 809. So, how will you going to write there? 8, 9. No, you have to write in the place of tens. Tens is not there. So, you have to use that 0. So, 809 means 809. It means 809. So, have you understood this chapter, children?
Place the right numbers of beads on the wire of the abacus. Write the number in figures and in words. Now, this is the way, teaching way of abacus way. So, here I have drawn three lines here. Straight. That is a wire. That is called a wire. And I have written the H, T, U. Before that, I told you H means what? 100. T means what? Tens. And U means unit. So, I had given you the number, children. Which number is that? Can you tell me? 4 means unit. 5 means tens. 2 means 100. So, how will you spell this? First, what you have to always, you have to go from the backward numbers. So, back numbers are 4. Back number is 4. Always go to the unit place. So, 4. Now, I am making your beads. 1, 2, 3, 4 beads are there. How many beads are there? 4. And the tens, in the place of T, tens. How many is there? 50. So, you have to make 5 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 beads. Okay? And the last one, 200. So, your 2 beads are there. Now, how will you read this? Just look at here. Here, how many is there? 2. Here, 5. Here, 4. So, the children, the answer comes 254. So, how will you going to write here? 2. H means 100. Can you tell me the spelling of 100 once again? H, U, N, D, R, E, D. 100 and 54. 5 means 50. So, F, I, F, T, Y. 50. 4. F-O-U-R. So, how will you going to write, read this? 254. 254. So, now you understood this? The second step, the same way. Now, 183. Again, you have to write here. U means unit. Tens. 100. So, always go from the backward. पीछे से हमेशा जाना चाहिए, आगे से कोई भी number लिखना नहीं चाहिए. हमेशा हमें unit से ही start करना है. तो, unit is 3. So, make your 3 balls. 1, 2, 3 beads. And the second one, 8. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So, total how many are there? 8 beads. And the last one, 1. So, sing 1. Okay? So, how will you going to write here? 100. In the tens place, 80. And the unit place, 3. So, 183. So, how will you going to write in the spelling? 100 and 83. Like this way you have to spell and you have to write in words like this way. Now the third one, same way. Just look at your, which number is your? 741. Unit, tens, 100. Unit, tens, 100. The unit place there is a 1. So, you have to make your 1 ball. And then the tens place there are 4. So, you have to make your 4 balls. How many balls? 4 balls. And the last one in 100 place 7. So, you have to make how many balls, children? 7 balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 balls. So, how will you going to write here? 7. Here, how much are there? 4. And here, 1. So, 741. You have to read like this. 741. Whenever you write from the backward. But whenever you are going to read, you have to read from the first number. 100 plus 740. 741. How will you going to write 7? S-E-V-E-N. 700. H-U-N-D-R-E-D. 100 and 41. So, like this way you have to spell. Look at the abacus way. Write in 100 times unit. Then write in the spelling. So, the three steps are there to understand, children. And I showed you how to understand these things by using this project work. So, like this way you can make You can display the things in your book or something. You can look at the textbook. There are some bags I showed you. You can draw the bags of 100. You can make a beads of tens and then units. So like this way you can draw and you can understand the 3-digit number easily. So that way understanding 3-digit number, the steps I've told you to clearly. So try to do it in your book. If it is very difficult, just go through the numbers 101, 102. Write it in your notebook from 100 to 999. So you will get the numbers in your mind and you can split that number. Split the numbers by 100, tens and units. But the short form you must know, H means 100, T means tens and the unit, U means units. Have you understood this, children, the part 2? Take out your notebook of maths, write these things, draw it out and write the 100, tens and units properly. And the last things you have to draw this abacus way, write the numbers and the words. And whatever the in your textbook, just write it in your notebook. So you can by heart that and you can practice well the sums all. So we'll go to the third part in the next video. So thank you, children. Bye. See you.